On tonight's show, the Pacific Islands performing arts students get a new building to house their growing talent.
We're just blessed to have this place and it's blessed to be a part of it.
Pasifika Spring Hill inmates join together to help a charity.
It's touched our lives, you know, in so many ways. It's given us our identity.
And Southside's talent line up for the next factor.
But first, Sky City's deal with the government to build a multi-million dollar convention centre looks set to go ahead, much to the objection of the Pacific Island community. Pacific Islanders are the most at-risk problem gamblers in New Zealand, and now there's a focus on limiting the potential damage caused by the deal. Sainelia Chadwick reports.
Behind the flashing lights and pokey machines, there lies a darker story.
We hear a lot of stories from families who have no food in the house, stories of families who are desperate because either a family member or a husband or wife is gambling all their money away.
More than 20% of problem gamblers are of Pacific descent, the most of any one ethnic grouping in New Zealand. Mapumaya's Pacific manager, Basile Ahoni Siitia, helps Pacific people overcome their addiction through a free helpline. She's worried Sky City's extra 230 pokey machines will lure more Pacific people through its doors.
There's a huge amount going now. Okay, so I think that more machines, of course, you know, available. I think that there's more opportunities for our Pacific Island people to gamble.
So why are Pacific people overrepresented? Ahoni Siitia says part of the answer lies in the culture.
Gambling is a normalised activity within our Pacific culture. I think that we've been brought up in the activities of gambling to raise funds.
Salvation Army's Pacific advisor, Melino Maka, says attitudes towards problem gambling need to change.
Our community, they used to say, I don't care. Unless there's a member of your whānau, of your family, will have a direct impact on gambling. And then by then it's too late.
Despite the Sky City deal going ahead, the Pacific communities won't fold and will now change their focus to limiting the potential damage of the extra pokey machines.
We need to think now is to work out how we're going to deal with the effect of gambling amongst our community. Because if you look at it, it's not a... you can't see the tangible evidence until it's already happened.
The challenge of curbing Pacific problem gambling doesn't seem to be getting any easier.
Pacific older people have now got their own SeniorNet computer centre in Auckland, believed to be the first of its kind. For Pacific, it's been launched by Tour Pacific Advocates. The organisation runs programs for the elderly while raising awareness of elder abuse. Tour Pacific used World Elder Abuse Awareness Day to officially open its SeniorNet centre in Otahu. It's hoped it'll help Matua learn how to use computers and technology in their everyday lives. To get things started, SeniorNet gave a $2,000 grant for the centre.
A West Auckland Pacific health provider is doing innovative work to ensure its people are kept healthy.
Their programs are showing signs of success, particularly in the area of diabetes, which is at epidemic proportions in New Zealand. Barbara Driver with this report.
For this group, this is literally a walk of life, a foot in the right direction, and that direction is survival.
I think diabetes is a significant problem for us, and unfortunately within Pacific there seems to be a growing number of people that are having diabetes.
Tevita Funaki knows what diabetes has done to his community. As CEO of a Pacific health provider, he sees it every day. More than 800 of West Faunal's patients live with the disease.
You can look at things, dialysis, you can go blind, amputations and so forth.
West Faunal's diabetes patients are just the tip of the iceberg. Shocking research published in the New Zealand Medical Journal shows 40% of Pacific people in New Zealand have diabetes or pre-diabetes. It's why West Faunal has taken action with programs specifically suited to Pacific people.
The Caring Does Matter program that we started up, the aim of that was just to improve people's adherence to their medication.
Medical staff take a proactive approach and phone patients when their pills are due. The idea is to let patients know they care about them.
That's good news to a patient. Oh my gosh, you know, the medical practice or the doctor or the nurse, they care about me. This must be important. And I think to a Pacific person, it extends their concept of community.
Nurses also do home visits.
We get a better response from patients going to their homes. Also, going to their homes, taking blood pressures and sitting down and discussing their diet. Yeah.
Lucy O'Brien is one of those patients. West Fornell has helped her get her life back.
Right. It was really weak. It was difficult, but then with the help of my doctor and nurses, and I take supplement as well, so I'm here today, otherwise you wouldn't see me.
West Fornell also coordinates around 22 fitness groups in the area.
Unfortunately, over the years, the funding for those programs has been diminished.
In the recent budget, the government announced a $35.5 million increase to tackle diabetes over the next few years. The Green Prescription Program, which encourages patients to be more active, has had its funding doubled. But health providers say not enough is being spent on prevention, given diabetes is estimated to cost the country $900 million a year.
Even though maybe only 10% of people become really active and keep it up, because it's quite a cheap intervention, it's actually just as cost effective as, say, some of the drugs we use, like a statin for cholesterol.
But West Fornell knows what's working for its people. Its challenge is finding the money for it. Pacifica is about community, and this community is about staying alive.
To the arts now. The Pacific Institute of Performing Arts, or PIPA, has officially opened the doors to their new home in Avondale.
They have taken over an iconic shoe factory and plan to continue making products with a certain amount of soul. Tangaloa Tele Osone Okesene has more.
The community turned out in force for the opening of the new Pacific Islands Performing Arts Centre, or PIPA as it's more commonly known.
I am pleased. You know what? It's like, it's the prep has been like setting up my wedding.
To come back and celebrate into a new opening, a new door that's opening up for PIPA and all the young generations, the young PI actors that are coming through. They're just blessed to have this place and it's blessed to be a part of it.
A branch of Best Training PIPA's a success story of the vision of founder Anita Finnegan. Best has been instrumental in putting many Pacific youth on the path to employment, and in the few years that PIPA's been up and running, their successes are many.
It's done a lot for me. It's opened many doors for me. I've done shows with Auckland Theatre Company, done feature films as an extra. I've toured New Zealand and Australia with the Duffy Books and Homes. I was one of the role models for that.
Opened by His Worship the Mayor of Auckland, it's a purpose-built building. They've taken the iconic Arthur Lydiard Laser Shoe Factory and given it a new lease on life as PIPA Avondale.
We've got three studios upstairs, and downstairs we have two studios, including a computer room, and a space for the students to completely relax, a common room. They've never had that. You know, we had the one kitchen where the staff and the students had to share. Oh my gosh. And the fact that we have our own areas is amazing. And a conference room. It's so flash. We've never had one.
After the break, Spring Hill prisoners use their voices to give back.
I felt it was God's calling on my life. You know when you feel something in your heart that fits? This is one of those projects.
Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. Spring Hill Prison hit the headlines this month when riots broke out at the medium security facility.
But the day before that happened, our very own Sandra Kailahi travelled to the prison south of Auckland for the launch of a new CD, Va'afa'ola, by inmates from the Pacific Focus Unit Choir.
It's a first for the prison and for many of the choir members who've been singing together for about 3 years. Sandra Kailahi has the details.
Pacific hymns of praise, but the words have taken on a whole new meaning for this unique choir at Spring Hill Prison.
He's touched our lives, you know, so many ways. He's given us our identity. Now, what do you say to that, you know?
This prisoner, we'll call him Oliver, because we can't identify him or any of the others for legal reasons. is part of the Va'afa'aola Choir. He's been in Spring Hill for 6 years. The choir has changed his life.
It's been like rediscovering, you know, something that I've lost long time ago. You know, my culture, my faith.
The 44 male choir are part of the Pacific Focus Unit, or Vakafa'aola, at the medium security prison. As part of the men's rehabilitation, the staff asked choir master Tangaloa Peter Su'a to take on board the project to record the CD.
I felt it was God's calling on my life. You know, I'd just finished one assignment with another church in December last year, and this came up like the following week, and it's almost just instant. And it's just, you know, when you feel something in your heart that fits, this is one of those projects.
And it's a sentiment echoed by the staff at Vakafa'aola, which was set up in 2007 to reduce the prisoners' risk of re-offending through a culture-based environment.
So it's about reuniting the men with their culture, giving them a sense of who they are, where they come from, and not being afraid to say, like, hey, I'm Pacific and I'm proud of it. And singing is part of our culture, as you know. And it's, you know, it's in our blood, it's in our bones, and it's part of who we are. So promoting that to the men is something that we're proud to do, and it's something that they're proud to do as well.
It's been a journey of discovery for all those involved.
I actually had to keep an open mind, you know, because I've been in jail for a few years, and there's that jail mentality. And, you know, I had to put that aside and actually accept the man. But, you know, him being a Pacific Islander wasn't all that hard.
The prisoners began to get behind the project despite some hesitation whether it would go ahead. The choir picked out 10 songs for the CD, and Tangaloa helped with the arrangement. One was even written by a former inmate.
We understand those hymns, and I think we'll feel it more than anyone else because, you know, it was written by one of us. You know, and when we sang it, it's, you know, it's from the soul, it's from the heart. You know, simply because we understand it. It's not just words that you mix that make some nice noises or sounds. We actually understand what it means.
I'm proud that a lot of them, their faith has grown through this, you know, because for me it's not just teaching music, it's also encouraging their faith. You know, a lot of them go to church, have gone to church outside these walls, and so now they've come here and it's almost like, okay, this is their place of solace in the whale, you know, especially on Sundays when they sing their praises to God, they're glorifying God, it's coming from their hearts. And so you feel that.
For many of the men in Vakafa'aola, this CD is part of their rehabilitation. They've decided to give all the proceeds to the Cancer Society. It's their way of giving back through the power of music.
I think we did this for ourselves first, you know, so we can actually cross that bridge, you know, towards rehabilitation and stuff. I just hope that the community will actually embrace it, you know, and actually help us out.
And if you'd like a copy of the CD, go to our website for details, or you can enter our competition. We've got 5 copies of Va'afa'aola to give away. All you need to do is answer this question: which organisation will get all the proceeds from the album sales? Just go to our website for more information. Time now for some community notices with a track from new artist Tree with her debut track available.
Thanks, Lulu, for helping out with the notices. Coming up next, body-changing ambition.
I always liked muscular, you know, body, muscular body. When I was overweight, I was 140 kilos. You know, when we have family photos, I had to squeeze my stomach inside and smile at the camera, you know.
Back to Tagata Pasifika. Well, there's a whole bunch of talent shows on TV nowadays, the likes of New Zealand's Got Talent, New Zealand Idol, the list goes on.
But in South Auckland, they have their own way of turning out stars. The Next Factor, initially an effort to rise above bullying, has given young Pasifika people hope for the future, as John Pulu found out. When I had you to
myself, I didn't want you around. They came in groups. And sang their hearts out. Vying to be stars. For some, it's a chance to change their lives. For this crew, Blackwood Exit, the road forward is one less travelled.
Because, like, for the dark side, like Mangere, Rewa, Waitara, South Auckland, like, woods, like for the hard life, struggles we go through, and like exits for like our way out, music.
Yeah. And we're just basically rapping about our life and stuff.
It's music that these boys are counting on to change their future. They are their own inspiration. It's their personal experience that motivates them.
We want to support our, like, our lives out there, because a lot of South Auckland people have gone through the same things that we have. So we're putting out there that it's all right, even though you've gone through it and we've gone through it. This is how it is, and this is how we want it to be. We're trying to change the stereotype.
It's a passion for music that's brought the trio together, giving them a second chance.
I kicked out of school at a young age, and we just had to find an alternative education somewhere to learn, somewhere to better our chances in life, kind of thing.
Was that the real wake-up call for you?
Yeah. It's different.
My mum woke me up.
But a year ago, one of the lads got a cold, harsh dose of reality. Solomone, a father at the age of 17.
First thing that came to my brains was I gotta get a job. And went out there looking for a job, and then got two jobs. Started working 7 days a week. And sometimes when I finished one job, I went to the other job.
Juggling his jobs and pushing to break into the music industry is his family's ticket to a brighter future.
And I want it bad that we all practice late and we try and make it happen. Yeah, perform, do gigs. Sometimes we get paid for it, sometimes we don't, but we get out there and make it happen. So hopefully she has a better future.
Ready to go to the next level, he called on his brothers to enter the Next Factor talent competition.
From my haters, non-believers, starving, hungry, got me further than my living.
Be my best friend.
As long as you love me.
How my love, love, love.
This is their big chance to showcase their talent and possibly walk away with $1,000 prize money. The boys have chased their dream and have made the Next Factor finale. This is South Auckland's finest. Over 100 entries have been whittled down to 10 acts. A row of judges plus the audience vote will determine their fates. And now the moment of truth.
Second equal goes to Blackwood Exit.
Not quite the prize they were hoping for, but they don't go home empty-handed. The second place is a step closer to stamping their mark on the industry.
Where to from here?
Start recording songs at the studio, boost them up on Facebook, YouTube,
get our fans or and everyone else out there listen to our stuff and hope our music inspires them to
do what we do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hope they do what we do.
Well done, Blackwood Exit. All the best for the future. And thanks to Strive Community Trust for the additional footage in that piece too.
In our next story, a young man dreamed of becoming a super rugby player. But when that dream fell short, he emerged in a different arena in the sport of bodybuilding.
He entered the 2013 National Amateur Bodybuilders Association Auckland Champs, as Suwana K. Ahulele finds out.
While many dream of healthy living, for Tongan-born Sotela Fatui, it's a lifestyle.
I always liked muscular, you know, body, muscular body. When I was overweight, I was 140 kilos. You know, when we have family photos, I had to squeeze my stomach inside and smile at the camera, you know. I was, you know, and get to a point you feel you hate yourself.
A poor body image led to Sotela losing over 40 kilos in just 11 months and take the East Coast Bay's NABBA 2012 overall men's physique champion title. By his side, his wife Helen, supporting him all the way.
We trained together. We were both unfit, overweight. So we decided time for a change.
And today, he's a different man.
Right now, I'm doing 30 to 50 reps. I just use the cable machine right now. Sometimes I use the dumbbell. I like to mix a lot. If I can do it, you know, everybody out there, you know, can try this.
But his next challenge isn't so simple. Has his tough workout and diet prepared him for this event?
This is Auckland. It's a big city and best bodybuilder out there. But, you know, just life, you have to go there and then show what you got.
So Taylor's 2012 title means little at this championships.
And he's had to start from scratch. And for what I can see around, he's got some tough competition.
Feeling good. Yes. You have to enjoy it, you know.
And according to one with a professional eye, Pacific Islanders are built for the sport.
Got a lot of time for the island Pacific bodybuilders because they build muscle really easily.
And it's all come down to this at the 2013 NABBA Auckland Championships. It's an emotional time for Sotela.
There's a lot of pain and sweat. You know, I'm happy.
A tough competition sees Sotela take second place.
Well done, Sir Taylor. Well, do join us again next week when we discuss whether Pacific Realm Islands like Niue, Tokelau and the Cook Islands feel that they're second-class citizens in New Zealand.
Remember, you can catch all our stories and find out what's happening in the community online at tvnz.co.nz, keyword Tagata Pasifika. On Facebook, just like us. And we're on YouTube as well.
Take care this cold weekend. Tō whasui fua.
Mālo au pito.